it's Friday afternoon, it's raining, and I'm currently at Warilla High School. I just did my third pitch to all the Kui students here. The pitch went really good. Had about 20-odd students in there. A few of them have been part of AIME before. Showed a little clip and the kids got a little bit excited. And then once that was done, got to speak to a few of them. Found out one of my first mentees, her younger sister's here, and so I knew quite a few of them just because they had older brothers and sisters who I once mentored.
We're looking at getting 300 kids here for the Wollongong AIME program, so that's what we're going for, and we're hoping to see them all at AIME sessions really soon.
So we're at AIME headquarters, and we've just had an interesting collection of things arrive. Who's that then? Hello, Viv.
Handyman today.
What have you got here, mate? Walk us through it.
Lovely. Direct from London, England.
Yeah, talk
lovely
me.
Lovely big red telephone box.
So. Oh, my God.
Man, is, I guess, that when you're at HQ now, getting on your Skype calls.
Yep.
You'll be doing it from London, England.
And the booth has just been boosted.
Yeah.
I don't think it's done yet, Arthur. Patience is a virtue.
The real highlight for me so far would definitely be just hanging out with the kids, like, and seeing Kyle pitch. It's great to hear his story, and every time, like, I know I've heard I've heard him tell his story a million times now, but it still has an impact on me.
Today I'd like to share a little bit of my story. A lot of people know I did athletics, and I was lucky enough to make it to the highest level. I made it to the Olympic Games in the hurdles. I ran in Atlanta Olympics in 96 and made the Olympic final. And I look back at that as one of my highest achievements, one of the greatest things I ever done in my life. But I think back to the 10-year-old that I was in primary school, and I had the crazy idea, the crazy dream, and that took 15 years to come true. And I know how much work I put in to make it to the highest level. But I think back at high school, and finishing year 12 was one of my goals as well. And I made it through to year 12. I passed, and I remember finishing 6 years of high school, and that was really important to me. It was important for my mum as well. She never got through to year 12, so she really wanted me to make it through to year 12. So I look at that as one of my standout achievements that I made in my career.
We're just here at the Indigenous Australian Student Services at Southern Cross in Lismore. We've just had a really good meeting with the guys. We've come down here to the centre, to the Indigenous Centre, and we've seen all these awesome boards with all the Indigenous graduates from the university. There's another board over there which is a couple of names from being full, and we're excited about the program here because we want to see this whole room just full of these boards, and everyone else is keen to do it as well. So pretty awesome idea, and we thought we'd share it with you all.
Bienvenue à la journée d'harmonie.
Chucking the final touches on here, we've got a taste of harmony. Here, all the AIME crew, as you can see, all the food, everyone's prepared. We've got chicken, we've got sushi, Indonesian dish. Viv's been up at 6 o'clock in the morning here, preparing these beautiful sausages. I've been working hard on the Greek salad, as you can see. But we're all doing it here, taste of harmony, all cultures, all people coming together. We're enjoying the day.
Viv, we're at stage two. Walk me through what's about to happen. Yeah, any words for anybody out there, or just
Good luck, mate.
Well, that was the first phone call in our new telephone booth.
First year primary education students.
Okay, we're here with Nadia and Neal. She's just pitched to around about 300 first year management students at the University of Wollongong.
Yeah, we're pretty good, I would say. They are all first year students, so for them a lot of this is a bit overwhelming, but still when you're looking out into the audience while you're playing the video, their eyes are on the screen, so that's a good sign that they're actually paying attention and taking in our message. Even if they don't sign up, the fact that they've heard about AIME just means that it's getting spread around the University of Wollongong.
The last couple of weeks has been good to see that sparkle in the eye when you talk about the AIME program and say, look, this is here for you guys. We want to be here, we want to support you, we want you to get through school. And it's that sparkle in the eye when someone new hears about it and they're quickly to signing the forms. There's an awful lot of love that gets sold on. Hold up, you better hold on. I sound a little better as I get older. I'm bolder now because I know the score. Mr. Manager, tonight we're taking the bar and the door.
Just imagine the euphoria if we get it.
Let's do it. Let's do it. Come on, Cara.
How's that
lineup? No, not good.
Oh, come on. Do I have to readjust for the Dragons? Is that good?
Yeah, that's better.
Alright, come on, Dragons. Get in on it.
Yes! Come on! Oh!